is a story all about how my life got flipped, turned upside down, and I'd like to take a minute, just sit right there. I'll tell you.
Untold Stories of a Medical Student.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Happy New Year! I can't believe it's 2022. So today we're going to talk about some situations that have happened to me in the hospital. As a medical student, I've seen things in the hospital that I never expected to see in my life. And I've had some pretty crazy experiences. And these are some of the things that I would love to share with you. If my dog would stop bugging out.
This story is about the time that I delivered a baby. Hence the bear, who is the baby.
Okay, so I'm going to tell you about the time that I delivered a baby by myself. So I was in my OBGYN rotation, and part of the rotation was that you needed to do a 15-hour shift overnight starting from 5 p.m. till 8 a.m. the next day. And you're supposed to just be available for any birth that happened during that time. And mostly your job as a medical student is going to be to observe a patient giving birth, and just maybe you can help deliver the placenta, you know, stuff like that. But in my case, it was a little bit different. So I ended up getting a night shift on my first ever shift in OBGYN. And being on nights, I was by myself completely. There were no other medical students because all the medical students are during the day and there's only one medical student on at night. So I go in and I'm running late. It's really hectic because we had to get special access with our IDs in order to scan in and go onto the labor and delivery floor. Not just anybody can go in there because they could steal a baby or something. So my ID wasn't working and I had to find somebody who would let me use their ID in order to get into the floors. So I arrived early, you know, I was supposed to be there by 5 o'clock. I got there by like 4:30, tried my ID and I couldn't get onto the floor. So now I had to find somebody who hadn't gone home yet who would let me into the floors so that I could use their ID for the night. Because otherwise I couldn't get to the call room, which was in a different building and you needed an ID for that. I couldn't get into the regular labor and delivery floor to get credit for my rotation. And the people who were working in the office who could give me access had already gone home. I'm texting everybody, I'm calling people, I'm like, is anybody around? Who's even on shift today? And thankfully somebody was available who gave me their ID to use for the night. So by the time all of this was said and done, it was 5:15. And then I get told that the doctor that I'm on call with is one of the meanest doctors that there are on this rotation. He's like a stickler for being on time and he's really, really intense. So I'm like, oh my God, of course it would be my luck that I'm gonna be stuck with this guy on the first day and I'm running late on the first day. I have no idea who this doctor is. I have no idea how the hierarchy of the floor works, like who sits where, who does what. So I'm asking people to give me the rundown of how this works. And they're like, the doctor sit here, the nurses sit over there. Your doctor, he just showed up. Go ahead and find him and introduce yourself. So he walks out of the attending doctor's on-call room and goes past me. And I'm like, oh, hi, doctor. I'm just going to call him doctor, doctor. Oh, hi, doctor, doctor. So my name is Julia. I'm here. I'm a medical student on call tonight. And just letting you know that I'm going to be around on the floors. He's like, what time did you come in today? I'm like, oh, well, I got here at, you know, 5 o'clock, but I had some issues with my ID, and so now it's 5:15. He's like, don't be late again. Students who are late fail and have to retake the rotation. And I was like, well, I wasn't planning on it. At this point, this is like my last rotation of 30 years. I was like so done with the way that doctors talk down to medical students. So I really had to bite my tongue not to be rude. But I was like, I wasn't planning on it. Okay. And so from then on, I kind of just sat by myself. The night goes on and I'm just like writing essays and there's a lady and she's potentially gonna give birth, but we don't know. She's not like fully dilated. Whenever the attending goes in to check if this patient is dilated, he doesn't tell me anything. He's not like, oh yeah, come with me. Let's go check the patient out together. He just goes off and does his own thing. And I'm chasing after him all around the floor because there were two patients that were potentially gonna give birth and he's going back and forth between their rooms. But even when I go in the room, he doesn't tell me anything of what he's doing. He just kind of checks if they're dilated and then he leaves. So I had no idea if anybody was gonna give birth at all or what the situation was gonna be. And it's getting later and later into the night at this point. Finally, we're just hanging out on the floor. I'm like a few seats away from him, kind of scared to look in his direction or talk to him or anything. And one of the nurses come out and says, the patient feels like she has pressure. And so the attending is like, is she saying she needs to push or just that she has pressure? And the nurse is like, no, she said she has pressure. So the attending's like, all right, let's go check. So I follow him and he goes in and he's like, yep, we're ready to go. Let's go. And he starts washing his hands and I'm there frozen like, what the frick do I do? He's like, put these on. And he gives me some booties that go all the way up to my knee. And I'm like, what are these?
What are those?
But I'm like, okay. So I just like drop everything I'm doing and I start putting them on over my pants and over my shoes. But I'm in the middle of the doorway. And he's like, don't stand there. So there's like 2 seconds where I'm like trying to put on boots, but also not stand in the wrong place. So he's like, is this your first delivery? And I'm like, yeah. And he's like, okay. I'm like, okay. He's like, somebody get this student a gown. And so thankfully a nurse actually gets me a gown and they're being nice to me. And attending is like, did you introduce yourself to the patient? Mind you, I did not introduce myself to this patient at all. So I walk up to the patient and I'm like, hi, my name is Julia. I'm a medical student. I'm just letting you know that I'm gonna be here. And she's like, okay. So thankfully that worked out. You should always introduce yourself to your patient beforehand. And he goes up in this lady's business, you know, the legs are swinging up, they're in the stirrups and we're all set up with like the appropriate gear and everything. Everyone's in position. The attending is like, okay, go on my left side. So I'm like, all right, so here I am. I'm like right next to the sterile field, like right next to the sterile table where there's some tools in case we need them. And it's me and then the attending's on my outside. So I'm kind of like sandwiched in between the patient, this like sterile table that I don't want to move, and the attending. And I'm like, how am I, this is like really up and close and personal for me to be watching this birth and not really doing anything. And I have gloves on and I have a gown on. And the attending tells the patient, okay, so you're gonna wanna push, like hold your breath for 10 seconds and push. And the patient starts pushing and the baby's head starts coming out. And I'm like, whoa, this is like amazing. I'm seeing the beauty of life happening right before my eyes, the miracle of life. Attending has his hands like kind of ready. And I'm like, okay, I guess he's just waiting prepared for when the baby comes. And then he says to me, grab the cord and pull it over the baby's head. And I'm like, what? And he's like, grab the cord and pull it over the baby's head. So I literally stick my finger underneath the umbilical cord, which I've never touched an umbilical cord in my entire life. And I pull it over the baby's head because it was wrapped around the baby's neck. And he's like, anterior shoulder, anterior shoulder. What the frick does that mean? I don't know what anterior shoulder is. I know anterior is front. Okay, I guess it's this particular shoulder right in front of me. So I go and I put my hands inside this woman and I kind of pull out this baby's shoulder, like, you know, carefully. I was like, am I pulling too hard? I'm kind of pulling the baby's head a little bit. I'm like, oh my God, am I gonna hurt this baby? Like, I don't know what's going on. He's like, anterior shoulder. So the baby's shoulder comes out and with it out comes the rest of the baby, who I then catch in my hands. And I'm just like, hi. And the baby is gray and the baby has all this stuff on it. And I'm like, is this okay? Is the baby okay? And the attending's like, put the baby down on the mother's chest. So I put the baby down in the mother's chest and the umbilical cord still attached. And the nurses come in and they start like rubbing down the baby, cleaning the baby up. And the baby slowly starts to become pink and then starts to cry. And it was insane. And then the attending just clamps the umbilical cord. He goes ahead and he allows the mother's companion to come and cut the cord. And then he starts to, he tells me, massage the uterus. Which I'm like, how do you massage a uterus? So he's like this, and he starts to massage the uterus. And the reason we want to massage the uterus is to help it contract back together so that we can, it prevents bleeding and it allows the uterus to go back to its normal size. So I'm massaging this lady's uterus and he's like pimping me, like, oh, what happens if, you know, the uterus doesn't go back to its size? What are we worried about? Things like that. If the uterus doesn't contract properly. But at all at the same time, he's slowly pulling out the placenta as this woman is kind of delivering her placenta. And then out comes the placenta, this big purpley blob thing that comes out. He puts it into a container off to the side. And there it is. It's like nothing ever happened. The woman has a baby. Everything else is normal. But I just delivered a freaking baby. At that point in time, I had so much adrenaline. I was like, oh my God, like, this is the craziest experience I've ever had. And I just want to do it again. Like, I really, really, really want to freaking keep delivering babies. And I'm hoping that the next mother is going to give birth. And I'm like, wow, am I going to be an OBGYN? Like, it was insane. Oh my God. So even though that attending was like really mean and had a bad reputation, I guess, for not really liking medical students, he gave me one of the best gifts I've ever had in my life, which was delivering this baby. Like, wow. Okay guys, so those are just some of the things that have happened to me as a medical student in the hospital. I have tons more stories, so if you want to hear more, just let me know. But I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!